Hey, welcome back into today's video. We're going to be talking about a YouTuber by the name of Simplykenna, or cozykitsune. They've been dubbed problematic on the platform due to various controversies, including cultural appropriation, racism, plagiarism, as well as leveraging their platform against other creators. They are over 800,000 subscribers on YouTube and over 400,000 on Instagram, so you can see that their platform is very large. On October 13th of 2018, they attempted to change their username, but was unable to when someone else had that same name and wasn't willing to give it up. That's when they finally decided on the name cozykitsune, saying that it means cozy fox. Now, there was a lot of speculation as to why this creator decided to rebrand in this way. Some were saying that it was her trying to escape her problematic past. Others were saying maybe she just wanted to change. Either way, in this video, we're going to refer to her as Simplykenna, or Kenna for short, because that's what she's most commonly known as. Let's go ahead and talk about the cultural appropriation. Google defines cultural appropriation, or misappropriation, as an adaptation of elements of one culture by members of another culture. This can be controversial when members of the dominant culture appropriate from disadvantaged minority cultures. Appropriate means appropriation is the action of taking something for one's own use, typically without the owner's permission. Now pay attention to that as we move forward through this video. One of the things that I noticed within the making of this video was that Kenna seemed not very happy with who she was, so she was taking bits and pieces of different things and putting it into her aesthetic to make herself into this kind of identity. One of those things being she changed her religion. Now, this is not uncommon for people to do, but her reasoning behind it was because she used to watch an old show that a lot of you guys probably know, called Avatar The Last Airbender.
How did your family react when you told them that you were converting? I think I kind of always subconsciously knew about Buddhism because of Avatar The Last Airbender. That show has a lot of Buddhist teachings in it, so I think that they were always kind of there in the back of my mind. And as I grew older, I became more interested and started doing more research. And that is how I found out about Buddhism.
Not to be mean, but for a lack of better words, ignorance, I believe, is what kind of breeds cultural appropriation. I believe a lot of these things start out as innocent, and that's where you get these Halloween costumes that are incredibly offensive. And also putting Buddha head statues in the background of your videos. Appropriation in this regard is best seen in United States 1960s and 70s out west, when the hippie movement came around, where everybody was like peace and love, because they was really in love with the peaceful Eastern cultures, and they became more surrounded by them through the rise of cellular devices, internet, and jobs, and things like that. That process is known as globalization. And since we were so closely connected, we had this ease of access to these things. People were just like, they were vibing with it. They liked it. The problem with it is they used it as an aesthetic. They used it as something that they just thought was cool and trendy and different. But they lacked the conviction of people that were really part of these religions. To give you an idea of real followers' convictions to the religions, it can best be seen, and I'm gonna give you guys a trigger warning and talk about some graphic stuff. Thich Nhat Hanh was a Vietnamese Buddhist monk who burned himself to death at a busy Saigon Road intersection on June 11th of 1963. He was protesting the persecution of Buddhists by South Vietnamese government led by Ngo Diem. So when you see the Buddha head used as decor, it's highly offensive to people that have true conviction to this religion. Compare it to if in the Christian religion, somebody took the head of Jesus Christ, used it as a fancy headpiece, and just started growing plants out of the top of it. It really puts cultural appropriation in a different light. Now, it's not uncommon by any means for young children to explore their identities and experiment with multiple things. The problem that Kenna was running into is that her viewers were trying to tell her the type of pain that she was inflicting on people who had true convictions to this religion. A lot of people thought it was very and perpetuating disrespect to the religious foundation of Buddhism, and to a very young and impressionable audience. This headpiece here is another bit of appropriation of the Romani people, which she was caught several times saying the G word, spelled G-Y-P-S-Y. A lot of people don't know this, but the Romani people are one of the most persecuted ethnic groups in the world. They moved from place to place, often not converting or conforming to folkways and norms of that society, leading to the birth of that derogatory term to hold them down. Kenna's viewers tried to tell her this. Hey Kenna, I'm sure you're not aware of this, but the G word is actually a slur. The Romani have came out multiple times saying this, but many people still think and fetishize their culture of wandering around. The truth, they are forced to wander around. The Romani get kicked out, chased, harassed, and beaten out of countries. Now, it's an interesting, sad story. If you guys want to check it out, give it a Google. I might put a link. I will put a link in the description for you guys to check this out. But much like the N-word, the G-word is meant as a derogatory slur to hold people under. And when Kenna was let know this, not just by one person, but multiple people, her response was this: thank you for the advice. It's the store's name. It's really out of my control. Then she goes on to say that she personally learned that the G word wasn't actually a slur until Hitler decided to use it as one. I think that running from the word and looking at it as a slur just gives people more power. Now, to understand how incredibly offensive this is, compare that if she was talking about the N-word. And this type of response and defensiveness is, it trends throughout this video, as you will see. Now, let's talk about the plagiarism. And plagiarism, by definition, is taking one's own work and passing it off as your own. Let's start this off by talking about a fox. Kenna posted on Instagram a fox drawing that she said was an original from her. But in the comment section, somebody said, "Did you get permission from the artist to use that fox?" To which she responds with, "I am the artist." And again says, "It's just a minimal outline of a fox. Nearly anyone's would look similar. But let's see if this is similar to everyone else's or a direct copy." So as you can see, the original artist is Katie Greff, and this was posted on May 7th of 2014. This is certainly a minimalistic drawing, but exactly a replica. She went from saying that the whole thing was being completely taken out of context and that no, she didn't steal or plagiarize, that there was a mistake, to finally posting somewhat of an apology saying that she didn't intend on stealing the fox logo, to which somebody said, "Don't lie, it fits line to line, it's traced," to finally posting a full apology, but not without saying that it was truly a misunderstanding and that the outline came from her sketchbooks years ago that she forgot about. And then she goes on to credit Katie Greff for the drawing, saying that she is only human and that she makes mistakes. But the mistakes that she is making are mistakes that she continued to make. People started pointing out her tattoos here. As you can see, this one says "Coffee on a Rainy Morning," and it was directly stolen from a Flickr picture that was copyright. You see these symbols right here? Those symbols stand for attribution. You must give appropriate credit and non-commercial. You may not use this material for commercial purposes. The same thing went for her cauldron tattoo, the Pinocchio tattoo, and the Love Grows Here tattoo. And this gets a little bit stranger because somebody asked if it was okay to get the quote tattooed on them because it's wonderful. And she responds with, "The entire concept of the tattoo, Love Grows Here with plants, is unique to me. So I would appreciate it if you didn't. I hope you understand." Someone else asking if it would be okay to, if they put it on their wall. To which she responded with, "I guess I wouldn't mind you drawing it to put on your wall as long as you make sure to give credit because it's my personal art. Just don't get it tattooed, LOL hee hee." Just so you're keeping up, at this point she's already taking bits and pieces of religions and philosophies, and now she's taking bits and pieces of artwork and quotes to add to her aesthetic, the aesthetic of her person, to build this thing. To what end? I'm not 100% sure, but was she doing this on purpose? This is another person by the name of Sleepy Charlotte who posted a picture that says "Love Grows Here." Now, if you don't know, "Love Grows Here" is a very, very popular quote that if you put into Google, there are endless, endless quotes and images. One Twitter user saying, "Be careful, Charlotte. You might get accused of copying Kenna. Kenna has accused people of copying her for simply having a similar aesthetic. Tread carefully. Kenna and her followers will not hesitate to attack." We're going to be talking about that a little bit later in the video. One of the people that she actually did attack was lunestelle. And she said, "She's already been attacked by them before, and she 100% did not deserve it. Charlotte, stay strong and beautiful." So these three comments right here are going to give you a little bit more of a feel of the situation. The first one says, I'd hand design all my tattoos. The next one saying that people tend to change one tiny letter or color or line of someone's art and then think it's something completely different. I'm simply asking you to make sure it's not this tattoo that you're getting. Then she goes on to say that, sometimes work is copyrighted, so if you just get whatever art on you that you want, you might end up with a lawsuit someday. I think it's best to just use common sense and common courtesy and not copy people. So it's very bizarre, very strange that somebody that is actively plagiarizing and copying to be saying this. And to me, it looks a lot like projection. Psychological projection is a defense mechanism people subconsciously employ in order to cope with difficult feelings or emotions. So this person is copying, is plagiarizing, is not liking who they are and is attempting to rebuild themselves of something else. And this must be a very painful thing, a very painful feeling deep down. And so when they are doing these things and they see other people doing it, they're projecting these unwanted feelings of things that they are actually doing, but they're also feeling very guilty for doing these things and not generally being happy with themselves. As you can imagine, somebody that keeps on accusing anyone that has a similar aesthetic as her, with such a large following, her followers are gonna think that this person's telling the truth and gonna go attack those people. And she played a great part in the perpetuation of this sort of agenda. Here it can be seen that somebody says that a girl named Emilia copied her art, and to which Kenna replies that she's not surprised because she can see that plagiarism is alive and well. And we already know at this point the depth and length that if not knowingly and consciously, subconsciously, that Kenna is willing to go. On January 17th of 2017, a YouTuber Emilia released a video calling out simplykenna for some pretty terrible things.
A specific YouTuber called me out on her Twitter for what I had been doing, and all of her followers decided it was a great idea to start attacking me on all social media platforms that I own.
Simplykenna has hundreds of thousands of subscribers, and Emilia only had a few thousand, and the dynamic is completely different at that point, and the irresponsibility that this situation was handled with was on another level. The hate that Emilia got over just copy, let's say she did copy Kenna, she received death threats over pictures.
People were calling me a whore and a slut and a B word, a C word, which was just completely profound. They told me that I should just go back to slutting it up and being a whore because it worked better for me to be a basic white girl. Everything that they've said has just been downright horrific. I cannot believe the words that come out of people's mouths, but the worst one of them all is someone told me to kill myself. Really? You're...
See, when Kenna has such a young and impressionable audience, and it's that big of an audience, when she makes a public statement on any type of social platform, if that energy is received irresponsibly and not directed in a good direction, bad things can happen. And to make things worse, Emilia was going through a very difficult time, having her sister, mother, and father pass away all around the same time span. And when Kenna was made aware of this, somebody saying that they just found out that Emilia's mother died this summer, her sister died in a car accident this past week, and her father has stage 4 cancer. So I think people should leave her alone now and stop attacking her just because she is copying. Kenna, in all honesty, there are more important things in life than worrying about whether or not someone is copying off of someone else on YouTube, to which I 100% agree. Somebody said, I posted an Oscar Wilde quote saying imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, for the most part saying that Emilia copying Kenna is her saying that she really likes what she's doing. But Kenna's response to this, completely overlooking what she had just found out, says, I personally don't agree with that, saying that that is not a form of flattery when she should be more sincere. And she was immediately called out for it, to which she responded, I understand that you went through hell in your life, but you need to understand that that has nothing to do with me. And going through hard times does not condone or excuse actions you make that are wrong. I asked you nicely to stop, and you said you would, and then you began literally photoshopping my own photos. I mean, what is this other than immaturity? When somebody tells her the depth of a very tragic circumstance, for her first thought to be like it's not her fault, and it's to shift the blame off and completely be without empathy, to not understand or feel what in the shoes of this person is going through, is really beyond words, and makes me really understand, especially here accusing of blatant plagiarism when she is so obviously doing that and projecting this. I can see why a lot of people started unsubscribing, because this behavior alone is, it does not need to be supported. Another smaller creator that was accused of copying Kenna's aesthetic was one called Lunestelle. We're going to call her Lune for short. But what we're going to do, this was based off of Instagram pictures and a Disney vlog. We're going to compare Disney vlogs for her, Kenna, and then just random vlogs from other people to show you that no one was copying anyone, and this is pretty much the same throughout. So this is video one. That was video two. That was video three. Now, if you could guys tell me which one was the random, the Kenna one, or the Lunestelle, let me know in the comment section below. To give you guys another good example, we're just gonna go ahead and Google images search hipster girl, and I wanna show you that Kenna's aesthetic, and this aesthetic in general, is, there's a lot of people that do that. So there you go. You can see that they all wear similar hats, have similar styles. Usually this round hat for some reason, I don't know why, various colors of that round hat. Still don't understand that round hat. Another one of that round hat. So as you can see right here, this is going to speak massive volumes about the Lunestelle situation. In one hand, you have her saying that she never wanted any hate to happen to Lunestelle. And the bottom one saying that she is thanking everyone who did defend her and her career. So it's one praising the attacks, and another one saying that she hopes she doesn't get any attacks. So after all this stuff happened, she finally released an apology, but this apology, which is now deleted, was probably the worst apology that I've ever seen on YouTube. It was, yes, creative, but it was written in a way of poem, and a lot of people were very skeptical that she probably plagiarized the poem apology.
Am I a human? Am I a monster, or am I something in between? You see, I tried to be the hero, but that's not real. I've done bad things. I've told tales.
She deleted that apology and then worked very hard to make another apology that was received a little bit better.
And I never gave proper credit to the artist or asked the artist if it was okay to redraw their art, and honestly, that's deceiving and manipulative. And even if I didn't think so at the time, even if at the time I didn't think I was doing anything wrong, I think over time I did come to realize that what I was doing wasn't right, but I never did anything to fix it. There were also tons of things that I just took and used as.
She went point by point and apologized for everything, but a lot of people wasn't very accepting of this apology. It currently has 25,000 likes to 17,000 dislikes, and I think most apology videos usually tend to have a lot of dislikes on them in general. But the reason that I wanted to talk about this is because it seems that the behavior is still an ongoing thing. People are still making videos. The most recent one, and this is what inspired me and put me down the rabbit hole, was by a YouTuber named Common Nobody. It's a pretty good video. I'll put it in the description below. But in the video, she goes on to explain how she reached out to Kenna, and they had a brief back and forth conversation, and she thought that Kenna was going to be open and talk about these things, as Kenna said in videos that she would respond or talk to anyone that had any questions about these things. But that did not happened prompting her to make this video, and which prompted me to fall down the rabbit hole. And when I did fall down the rabbit hole, I will tell you, I couldn't have been prepared, because you hear stories about people doing plagiarism and taking things and using those things for their own credit, but this story was so detailed and so in-depth, I for sure wasn't able to get everything in it, but it painted a clear picture for me, and maybe even for you as well. You can let me know what you think about it. I don't think that this story is one of a girl that's evil. I think it's some more of a story of a young girl looking for identity, and this is not so uncommon, as a lot of people are doing this, and young children specifically searching for the identity, experimenting. The issue is that this was put out there for the public to see, and that's it's unfortunate, but it happened. And if there's anything that I'd like to leave this video on, it is that we are never the same person from one day to the next. We're always evolving, always different. And if we can begin to understand that, we can be a little bit happier with ourselves, because it's not the aesthetic out, but the aesthetic within that we need to embrace. And that just got cheesy, didn't it? Well, as interesting as this is always something that's more interesting to me, that's right, you guessed it, I want to know what you think. So why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below. Thumbs up, thumbs like. As always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. I think I messed up on my outro, but this was a good video. I did a lot of research, wasn't able to get everything in there, and I have another video to work on right after this. I did take like 6 days off, and that was not intentional. It was just I had a lot of things that I had to take care of, had to help my family with some things, so I do apologize for that, but I will say it's good to be back, and I missed you, and yeah, if you need me, you know how to get a hold of me, because, oh yeah, wait, we're fixing to launch a whole bunch of shirts for charity, and 100% of proceeds go to that charity. Look for that on the Twitter. Make sure you're following the Twitter, because I know that you're repping if you're repping vegan. How do you do that? All you do is subscribe, notifications turn on, be in the comment section every single video, because I'm going to be there. Greg the Cat's going to be there, and the rest of the Repstock community as well, and I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you. I'm hungry.